Thanks so much for joining us for CBN News Midday. I'm Ephraim Graham.
And I'm Lori Johnson. We're following breaking news from the United Nations this midday. Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas has just officially filed for an application for full statehood membership at the UN.
But in what will be a high-stakes face-off, Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu will argue against a new state. Chris Mitchell has this report now from New York City.
For more than 2 years in office, Netanyahu has called on the Palestinians to recognize Israel as a Jewish state and come to the bargaining table with no strings attached. Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas has refused to come to the table, deciding his best route to statehood is to bypass negotiations and go straight to the United Nations.
When the curtain does come down on the UN parade of speeches, the delegates will find that little has changed on the ground. Israel will still be a Jewish state without Palestinian recognition, and the U.S. and the quartet will still be trying to restart the peace process.
While dozens of Muslim nations support a Palestinian state, some Arabs are opposed. Syrian-born Wafa Sultan is a human rights activist and political commentator.
We're here, you know, the United Nations is going to be making a decision about a Palestinian state. What do you think is the underlying reason and motivation behind that effort?
To create another Islamic country. We have enough of those dictatorship. We don't need any more dictator country in our region.
Many are concerned that if the Arabs' mission for statehood is perceived as a failure, it could stir more unrest in the West Bank and Gaza and lead to a new challenge by Hamas. In any event, the White House influence over the process has been reduced for now, and it will be difficult to find a path that would lead the Palestinians to choose diplomacy over defiance. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, at the United Nations.
The logo Palestinians are using at the UN apparently suggests there is no Israel in the Middle East. The logo shows a map of Palestine, and it covers all of the land that Israel now inhabits. There is no Israel anywhere on the map. The logo says Palestinian Liberation Organization on top and National Unity below. The Weekly Standard Online says the logo indicates Palestinians have no desire to recognize a state of Israel. And CBN has issued a call to prayer for Israel as the United Nations considers the vote on Palestinian statehood. Many observers believe such a state could lead to devastating attacks on the Jewish state. CBN founder Pat Robertson has asked for prayer that the UN will not vote to create a Palestinian state, that Israel will never be divided into two kingdoms, that the U.S. will remain a strong supporter of Israel, and for the peace of Jerusalem.
Republican presidential candidates took their case to the important swing state of Florida last night. As David Brody reports, the economy and immigration took center stage.
Frontrunner Rick Perry became the target again, this time for a law the Texas governor signed allowing children of illegal immigrants a discount for in-state college tuition.
That kind of magnet draws people into this country to get that education.
If you say that we should not educate children who have come into our state for no other reason than they've been brought there by no fault of their own, I don't think you have a heart.
Why should they be given preferential treatment as an illegal in this country?
On the economy, Mitt Romney and Herman Cain plugged their business experience.
And unlike Governor Romney's plan, my plan throws out the old one. He's still hooked to the current tax code. That dog won't hunt.
But it was the unfamiliar face of former New Mexico Governor Gary Johnson who delivered the line of the night.
My next door neighbor's two dogs have created more shovel-ready jobs than this current administration.
There's a reason there's been two Republican debates here in Florida in the last 2 weeks. That's because Florida is critical. There is no frontrunner down here, unlike some of the other early primary states. David Brody, CBN News, at the Orange County Convention Center in Orlando, Florida.
David, thank you. The current economic crisis is particularly tough on young adults. New census data shows record numbers are still living with their parents. Many are also delaying marriage and fewer are buying homes. Young adults face the highest unemployment since World War II. Economists say there will be a ripple effect for at least a decade.
Investors around the world have been selling stocks furiously in recent days. The G20 nations are hoping a statement of financial resolve will calm market jitters across the globe. Meanwhile, the United States government is also trying to boost our markets and economy. But as Heather Sells reports, the outlook is not very encouraging.
The Dow plunged 391 points on Thursday, at one point down more than 500. Part of the fear this week came from the Federal Reserve's latest move. The strategy raised short-term interest rates to lower long-term ones. But economists doubt the plan will do much since U.S. interest rates are already near record lows.
The Fed did not deliver this time around. In fact, the Fed, what they did do was basically just try to alter the existing format for stimulus. And what it really didn't do was move those interest rates all that much.
The market's negative attitude is also influenced right now by gridlock in Congress. It rejected a funding bill on Wednesday. Conservatives objected to the bill's spending levels, and Democrats voted against the cuts. Afterward, Speaker Boehner tried to calm fears.
There's no threat of government shutdown.
The president is hoping his jobs bill will provide a remedy. On Wednesday, he stood in front of a crumbling bridge to explain just how the government can create jobs.
There is work to be done, and there are workers ready to do it. So let's tell Congress to pass this jobs bill right away.
Warnings this week about the world economy are also playing into global fears. And a new report shows another reason why so many families are struggling. The cost of raising a child jumped by 40% in the last decade. Experts say raising a child to age 18 now takes more than $225,000. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Would you pay more than $16 for one muffin? Well, the Justice Department did. A report from the department's inspector general found that it spent lavishly on legal conferences, and not just for muffins. At another conference, coffee was more than a dollar an ounce, and a snack break cost $32 a person. Forget this, Cracker Jacks, popcorn, and a candy bar. The report comes just as a new Gallup study finds that Americans believe the federal government wastes 51 cents out of every dollar it spends.
The U.S. Department of Veterans Affairs agrees to settle a religious discrimination lawsuit. Several veterans groups sued the VA for allegedly banning the use of religious speech during services at the Houston National Cemetery. Under the settlement, the VA promises not to interfere with prayers during burial services, not to edit or control the speeches of speakers at ceremonies or events at the cemetery, and not to ban religious speech or words like God or Jesus in condolence cards.
A satellite the size of a school bus is set to crash into the Earth today, but it still remains to be seen when and where it will land. These are actual pictures of the satellite tumbling through space. NASA says it won't affect the U.S., but some models put out by the Air Force show at least a possibility that America could get hit.
We believe that the risk is sufficiently low that no one needs to change their behaviors.
Now, when the satellite hits the Earth's atmosphere, it will break apart. Only about 26 pieces will actually hit the Earth.
Can family dinners make your children better people? A new study links family mealtime with the behavior of teenagers. Researchers from Columbia University found teenagers who do not sit down for family dinners are four times more likely to use tobacco, twice as likely to drink alcohol, and 2.5 times as likely to smoke pot. Experts say the family time gives teens a sense of belonging and security. It also gives them the chance to communicate with their parents.
One of the great benefits of the internet is supposed to be free speech for all. But a new study says Christians may not be getting the same freedom as others. Paul Strand explains.
The new media platforms of our world, Facebook, Google, Apple, MySpace, all promise a world of much more speech and more democratized. But the National Religious Broadcasters Association warns these platforms could well be the new anti-religious censors of our day. It studied the biggest and says only Twitter hasn't shut up Christians.
It was actually a pattern of anti-Christian censorship that's already occurred among several of them. And then when we looked farther, looked at their written policies, we found out that every one of them, except for Twitter, again, they get an A-plus from us. The rest of them get failing grades.
Colby May of the American Center for Law and Justice joined with Craig Parshall and others to study the new media platforms for the last year and a half.
There is, in fact, a kind of viewpoint censorship that's going on, and we need to go ahead and stand up and say, stop, not here, don't do it, wrong way, turn around now.
What's getting censored?
Right now it's on the issue of the gay rights agenda.
Apple's App Store has only bumped off two apps, and both were from Christian groups that oppose the gay rights agenda.
And you have to ask yourself, well, why just these two viewpoints of the hundreds of thousands that you have? And when you get the explanation as well, some people were ruffled, they felt they were offended by it.
Parshall complains the companies behind these platforms give them
the authority to strip content off whenever other users, for any reason, decide that they don't like the opinions of other users.
Then you're thinking, wait just a minute, we've crossed over into this netherworld of offense is now the justification upon which the rights we have as Americans to fully engage the culture and to debate all issues is going to be decided.
These panelists who came to Washington to discuss the new NRB study urged the Googles, Apples, and Facebooks of the world to instead use the First Amendment as a guide, unfettered free speech.
More speech is better than less speech. Open and robust debate and contending for the things that matter is essential.
Everyone's viewpoint ought to be allowed on these new media platforms.
Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Coming up, ministering to children, how the church in Singapore is sharing the gospel with the next generation.
John Mapes is 42, mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
Okay, so has anybody actually started saving for college yet?
No, not me.
No, you got time.
We actually started.
You have?
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. We figure you start saving a little now, or you'll borrow a lot later on.
Yeah, but how did you even know where to start?
Oh, I found out about the Gerber Life College Plan.
Call now for free information on the Gerber Life College Plan. It's easy.
It's pretty much worry-free.
Well, how could it be worry-free? What if something happens with the stock market?
No matter what happens, we get guaranteed safe growth.
So when she's ready for college, the money will be there.
And it doesn't take a lot of money to get started.
For as little as $10 a week, you can start saving for college and get guaranteed growth. Just call now.
Oh, it's a life insurance policy, too.
Oh, that's different.
And if she decides not to go to college, there's no penalty, so she can use the money for anything.
We've got to get started.
Yes, we do, because you're going to college.
Call 1-800-886-6882 for your free information. That's 1-800-886-6882.
And welcome back. An Alabama school superintendent will no longer allow pregame prayers before football games. The town of Arab, Alabama has opened its games with a prayer for about a decade. School officials will replace it with a moment of silence. The reversal comes after the Freedom From Religion Foundation claimed a parent was upset about the policy.
Rob Bell plans to leave the church he and his wife founded to pursue other opportunities. Bell is the author of Love Wins. That's the controversial book about heaven and hell that came out earlier this year. Mars Hill Church released a statement Thursday saying Bell is leaving to, quote, pursue a growing number of strategic opportunities and to devote his full energy to sharing the message of God's love with a broader audience.
Young people between the ages of 4 and 14 respond to the gospel more readily than adults, yet the church only dedicates a fraction of its efforts to reach them. Now a growing number of leaders is working to change the way the church ministers to children. Stan Jeter brings us this report from the 414 Window Summit in Singapore.
It's an entirely different way of telling the Bible story.
we believe Manga is the language of the major unreached people group in the world, and that is the worldwide youth culture.
Norwegian missionary Roald Lidahl developed the Manga Messiah comic series after years of working in Japan. When he started using a visual style youth understood, the results astonished him.
Far more effective than anything else that we have ever had in the course of my 41 years in literature ministry, in any case. And we get reports basically from all over the world of people who have accepted Christ.
Lidahl's literature ministry has already placed 1 million copies in the hands of school children in Uganda.
The need for new tools and new strategies to reach a new generation has drawn Christian leaders here to Singapore from 93 different countries. They're attending the 414 Window Summit, and they all share a concern about reaching children between the ages of 4 and 14.
414 is a very important age because it's so responsive a time in the life of a young person. One dramatic statement is related to really the future of Christianity itself, because if we don't reach this generation, there is no future for Christianity.
The parade of new media products for reaching this generation was led by CBN's Superbook TV series, retooled for a contemporary audience. Mark McClendon is the CBN director for Indonesia.
There's just such a huge, like, pent-up demand, hunger for this. I think it's going to be explosive.
And once children become followers of Christ, they themselves can become agents of change.
I think one of the problems that we've had in our churches and ministries is that we've just sought to entertain children. We've not paid attention to that tremendous resource that the children represent.
I think the new things about this movement is providing space for children to be the primary agents of mission for the 21st century.
But for now, participants in the Singapore conference are leaving with a whole new set of tools and ideas for winning and mobilizing 414ers for Jesus. In Singapore, Stan Jeter, CBN News.
Up next, wounded warriors watch these American heroes make it up to the top of a mountain.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin, while it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch, and Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get 3 full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at 2 payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just 1 payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
The physical and mental scars our troops bring back from war can last a lifetime. Veterans treat those wounds in many ways.
The road to recovery for one group of wounded warriors includes pushing themselves to the very limit. Lee Webb brings us their story from Mount Rainier.
They put their lives on the line for our safety and freedom. Military men and women make a tremendous sacrifice on the battlefield, and many return home wounded and broken. More than 2 million disabled veterans live in the U.S., and that number grows every day.
It started off like any normal day. I was with a recon platoon.
Derek Ford served with the U.S. Army in Afghanistan, where an IED changed his life forever.
The entire floor of the Stryker had bubbled up from, you know, just the energy and heat that tried to penetrate through.
Derek lost his leg in the explosion. An injury like this can be debilitating, but not for this soldier.
Tighten the pull strap.
He's focused on proving it's only a wound, not a disability. That's why Derek pushed himself to the extreme.
I've jumped out of perfectly good airplanes. I've, you know, scuba dove in the Caribbean. You know, next on the list, climb a mountain.
Mount Rainier, or as the folks around here simply call it, the mountain, provides one of the most challenging mountaineering adventures anywhere in the U.S. About 13,000 people attempt to climb it each year. Only about half that many make it. And on average, about two or three die trying to make it to the summit. It is a challenge even for the most able-bodied climber.
So Derek, here you go. Okay.
Two other vets joined Derek in taking on this active volcano, including another amputee. Camp Patriot organizes the climb. The group specializes in taking disabled veterans on outdoor adventures.
That's the beauty of Camp Patriot, getting them out trying something new, or doing something they used to do, not knowing if they can actually do it.
Micah Clark founded Camp Patriot. He's a veteran himself, whose strong Christian faith gives him a heart to help heal returning vets.
Hopefully show them through our love and compassion that, you know, one, we're Christians, two, we're patriotic Americans, and that somebody loves them and cares about them. And that's the base to start from, and then you can open the door to possibly witness to them.
God, we lift up Eric and Derek and Mag to you, Lord, and just ask you to surround them with your angels, and protect them as they climb this mountain.
The trek up the mountain is grueling. Custom-made prosthetic limbs help the men grip the snow-covered terrain.
You don't carry them to the top of the mountain. They've got to do it under their own steam. You know, it's raising that bar again to show them that they have abilities to live life and not look at the disability.
A support team that includes active duty Rangers and Green Berets is on hand to help with the climb. Others are volunteers who just want to say thank you.
I believe it's my responsibility to do it, that I am my brother's keeper, that when guys come back wounded, it's not the government's job to find them and to assist them. I think every Christian has a responsibility to be our brother's keeper.
Retired Green Beret Gil Magallanes is one of the disabled vets making the climb. He says these extreme adventures help overcome the mental wounds of war.
One of the biggest factors about keeping me from becoming a couch potato, depression, PTSD, I got to keep challenging myself.
In this loose snow, you quickly realize it's best to find someone else's footprint and literally follow in their steps. We're a little over an hour into the climb. And even though this is a fairly steep ascent here in loose snow, this is the easy part, we're told.
The summit attempt is the most demanding section of the climb. The men must wear ropes and harnesses. Facing below freezing temperatures, the team navigates steep volcanic ridges, crosses over moving glaciers, all while fighting the high altitude for every breath of the thin air. The team eventually makes it to the top, 14,411 feet to the summit of Mount Rainier. These wounded American heroes beat the odds, reigniting their fighter instincts and proving to themselves that anything is possible.
When you see guys with one leg stomping to the top, and then you think about what you can't do in life, and you see that, it really is humbling. And that's what allows them to earn back that was taken from them on the day that bomb exploded or they got shot.
I'm really glad that I'm out here, and I'm really glad that, I got to meet the guys that I've met. I'm definitely hoping to, build and sustain some relationships with these guys.
Relationships Camp Patriot uses to heal the wounds of war while showing these American heroes the love of Christ. Lee Webb, CBN News, Mount Rainier, Washington.
Attention those on Medicare with diabetes. You may be eligible for an upgraded meter.
If you're tired of stabbing your fingertips to test your blood glucose, we have news that could change your life. If you're on Medicare with diabetes, then you need to know there's an alternative method for checking your blood glucose every day. You don't need to stab your fingertips anymore. The Embrace Meter from Diabetes Care Club is easier to use and nearly painless. And the best news is that Diabetes Care Club would love to send you one of these meters. This method hurts less, and because you can see and hear your results, it may be easier to understand.
Your blood glucose reading is 89.
Call now to find out why. Nearly 250,000 patients have joined Diabetes Care Club. Membership is free. So is the call.
Call 1-800-833-8011.
Talk to Diabetes Care Club. You'll be glad you did.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll-free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
The Reverend Billy Graham will soon turn
93. 93. Wow. The popular evangelist does have a few health issues, but that hasn't stopped him from spreading the good news. He has a new book coming out and a new exhibit at the Billy Graham Library in Charlotte, North Carolina. The exhibit will showcase Graham's personal writings and those of his late wife, Ruth. The Billy Graham organization is working hard to connect with the younger generation. It has an active Twitter page and Facebook page with more than 300,000 fans. In a rare interview, Graham recently shared how working with his dad prepared him for the ministry.
Absolutely. And then to work with the men that we had on the farm, and we became a team of people. Yeah. And that developed my thought of having a team of people. All these things contributed to my ministry in the years to come.
Graham's new book is called Nearing Home, and it comes out next month.
Be one to read indeed.
Absolutely.
Well, that is going to do it for this edition of CBN News Midday. You can find information on all the stories you've seen right here at cbnnews.com.
And you can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you'll join us again next time. Have a great weekend, everyone.
Bye-bye. Attention, if you have diabetes.
Hello, I'm Alan Thicke. As the father of a child with diabetes, it's important that I keep up to date with the latest in treatments and technology. That's why I'm happy to tell you about a breakthrough in diabetes care through CCS Medical. You don't need to stick your fingers anymore. This new meter allows you to test on your arm, so it's virtually pain-free. Plus, it uses gold test strips. Real laser-etched gold in every strip provides the ideal testing surface for one of the most accurate readings possible. Best of all, CCS Medical can send you this meter at no cost. With CCS Medical, they deliver your diabetes supplies to your home. They work with Medicare or your insurance to process the paperwork. They even have nurses certified in diabetes available to answer questions. And for a limited time, CCS Medical will also send you a diabetes ID bracelet. All this from a company trusted and recommended by thousands of doctors around the country. Call CCS Medical today.
One Monday morning, I woke up with incredible pain. Within 1 week, I ended up being admitted into the clinic. They diagnosed me as being septic, pretty much near death. We really took this in faith and in prayer to God. The Lord talked to my spirit during that time, and he said, you know, it's not a point of understanding, it's a point of faith. Within 2 months, all infection had completely disappeared. I really felt that this one time in my life, it was going to be the time that the Lord was going to take me on to great victory.